Hello there, welcome to this video. We will see here how to put an organized text and links with Adobe Dreamweaver CC. This tutorial continues the beginner tutorial in this show. If you need help, check the full guide in the video description. In the previous video, we saw how to use Dreamweaver in general, so we can start making the basic structure of our website. So create the necessary div tags, one for the banner, one for the central background, and as many other div tags as the text columns you want to add, for example 3. Then it's important to add the right properties to each div tag, for example they are placement. Turn live view on and arrange them all in the desired way. Remember to add the div tags interested in the selectors list, preceded by a hash. To make all faster, click on the plus while the pointer is on the interested div tag. We'll add some borders to highlight where the div tags finish. Let's see how the text works. Turn live view off and pick one of the div tags. A div tag can be seen as a text box on its own, so a small space where you can write in, as it is shown by default. You can edit the text content simply clicking inside and typing normally using the design view. This will edit the code that is on the left. And it works vice versa too. However, it is not as simple as it seems. If you type a sentence that is not short, Dreamweaver will enlarge the text area by default, and this risks to mess up the original structure. In this case, check with live view and correct the layout every time you set the text content of a div tag. Especially in complex websites, you need to adjust the layout of the right div tag. If it's first box, the div tag that messed up the structure, you need to adjust its margin properly and not others. Moreover, it must be clear the difference between a simple text and a paragraph. A paragraph, indicated through a P symbol in the HTML code, includes a compact piece of text that starts from a new line and has a safe line in the end. This is created when you press the Enter key, for example. New lines are indicated through the NBSP paragraph, indicated in bold. Any text inside the 2P and /P symbols represents a single paragraph that does start in a new line. This explains why our sentence is put even lower than expected. Simply remove the P symbols to remove the paragraph and consider the sentence on its own, without new lines. Remember that the NBSP command represents a new blank line. If you write on it, it will be replaced with the text. Let's suppose to manage this text properly. The text is ruled exactly like the div tags through the CSS file attached, through a tag called body tag that affects just the text and nothing else. In sources select the CSS file and in selectors add body. Don't add any hash since it is not a div tag. The properties given to the body tag will affect any text content in the project. For example, if we put color to the body tag, all the text will have such color, paragraphs and non-paragraphs. However, the body tag properties are the less important ever. If you put a different text color for a div tag, the text inside it will assume this color and not the one indicated by the body tag. This changes the text properties between div tags, but not inside a div tag. To do this, we need to use headings. Don't mind about the layout at the moment. At the bottom of your project, there is a window called the Property Inspector. If you don't find it, simply go to Window above and click on Properties. This lists the main properties related to the piece of code where your pointer is. If you are analyzing the text, its properties will be shown. Here, right next class, you can turn in bold or italic the text selected in your div tag. Very important is the format. You can choose between paragraph and different headings. Each of these represents a subgroup of text that has its own properties inside the same div tag. Apart from using B and I buttons, let's suppose to put as an heading one of our paragraphs. The number simply recognizes one of the possible headings. By default, an I number means an I font size, but they are fully customizable. So we can point at one paragraph and choose an heading as format. This will change its properties, even if it's inside the same div tag. Each heading is recognized in the code through an H plus the related number. As the standard paragraphs, they start from a new line and are separated from the other pieces of text in the end. A little above properties, you can see that the paragraph P and the heading H represent different IDs. This means that you can edit them separately like you did with the text inside different div tags. Mind that the properties given through the P or the H symbols do affect the text more than the properties given through the div tag properties or the general body tag. So, if we simply want to edit the heading, just point at it and click on the plus in selectors. The H letter will appear beside the div tag name. Then simply play with the properties window. So each div tag can have its own text style, but even its text can have different properties, up to 7, from the paragraph to heading 6. Just when finishing with the text inside a div tag, you can adjust its layout. So change the margin of the paragraph and the headings to add or remove blank spaces, and then adjust the layout between the div tags later. Let's see how to make links. Links are made to bring the user to a desired content. That can be another website page, a download, or even any image or video. The link is applied exactly like the B and I buttons, so simply on the text selected at the moment. Then in Property Inspector, next to Link, you can click on the folder to browse for the file interested. If it's a website, simply browse the .html file related. If the file is not included in the local root folder yet, Dreamweaver will ask you to copy it there. So simply click on Yes. These links are called hyperlinks and are indicated through an ahref line in the code. However, to test this link, it's not enough the live view. It is better to test it through a browser. Next to Inspect button, there is a word symbol. Click on it and choose one of your browsers to open the HTML page in full. Remember to save it first. You may need to use this powerful test pretty often, not just for the links, but to check if the div tags are set in the right way. In fact, what appears good in Dreamweaver may not in a browser. To have hints in positioning, watch the related video in this show. Even more, you can add a link of an external website. Simply copy and paste the web address in the link section. This is all. Now you can write the paragraphs and the headings you need for your website. Check the next video to know how to put backgrounds and images. Thanks for watching.